Good day, fellow investors. Today I want to discuss Seth Klarman's largest US portfolio position. It is Cheniere Energy, NYSE LNG. Now, I already made a video about natural gas, what's going on, what are the long-term trends, so don't forget to watch that because it will give you a much better understanding of this video and the company Cheniere Energy. Just a quick reminder, LNG, liquefied natural gas trade, is expected to boom in the next 10 to 20 years. And especially what is expected to boom are North American LNG exports. You can see here the first three columns, two columns, the first one is practically inexisting. 2015, no exports, then huge jump in 2025, and then again a huge jump in 2040. The US, thanks to the shale oil revolution, has become from a net importer and net exporter of oil and gas. Cheniere understood that trend and created an export natural gas facility. In order to export natural gas by boat, you need to liquefy the gas because then it's 600 times smaller in volume. And Cheniere is investing, I think they invested now about 20 billion and will invest another 10 billion in order to have 7 or 8 liquefaction trains in order to put the natural gas coming from the fields in Texas onto boats and ship them around the world, mostly to Europe and Asia Pacific, which are net importers of gas. And you can see here the trains that LNG is building. 5 trains are fully contracted, 6 trains coming on, 7th train, and then I think there will be another 8th train in order to export natural gas coming from the fields around Texas, which, where there is plenty of it, it is low cost to extract, so Cheniere can compete globally even with the additional liquefaction and transportation cost for natural gas. Just a reminder here, which this chart is already shown in the other video about natural gas. Natural gas prices vary a lot around the world because it costs to transport natural gas. Okay, short overview done. Now, what's the value? Where does Seth Klarman see the value in Cheniere Energy? As I said, 30 billion will be invested by 2020. And every year, the company is now investing about $4-5 billion. And it's just started, so it's really a growth startup that has 30 billion in investments. And if you look at this slide, you can see that the cash flow distribution per share, when all 8 trains are made, will be from $6.40 to $8 per share. 7 trains, $5.40, $6.40 per share. All the 8 trains will be probably built in the late 2020s, so I have taken 2027 as an approximate year to make my calculation. If, let's take the average, if a shareholder can expect to get $7 per share in cash distributions in 2027, you attach $7 per share a yield of 5%, thus we multiply the $7 with 20, we get to a stock price of 140 in 2027. As the current stock price is $45, in 10 years it should be 140. Of course, there will be also cash distributions from 2020 going onwards that are a little bit smaller, but however, significant. So you can expect a return of about from 12 to 15% if everything goes as planned. And we have seen the chart about the expected LNG global demand, so there is a high probability that everything will work out well. Thus, Klarman is already positioned to get the cash flows and then to make a 12 to 15% return in the long term. US will keep pumping out gas at a low cost, will have a moat, and Cheniere is perfectly positioned to take advantage of that trend. Now, what I want to close with is how to play that investment, because it's not linear, it won't be linear, and there will be lots of volatility around it. If we take a look at Cheniere's stock price, you can see in 2014-15 it was around 80, then it dropped to 24, and now it's around 45. You have to see, okay, I know that in 2027 the stock price will be around 140, so what's my expected return on investment? And then you can do the same as Klarman. He bought more when the stock price fell at 24, around 30, and then he immediately sold that position when it went up to 40. So he is trading around his long-term expected trend. You know, you have 12-15% in the long term, and then you can increase your returns by trading around short-term sentiment in natural gas prices, because when natural gas prices are low, also Cheniere's price will be lower. Margin of safety, 30 billion invested, long-term positive trend for LNG, long-term huge growth in demand for natural gas. So a lot of interesting developments for Cheniere. However, it's, let's say, a boring business, all done in 20-year contracts for where the customers want to secure their supply. Feel free to dig in into the sector if you're more interested. Please share your findings in this. Please share your findings under the video. We are here to learn all together and create a community of profitable, low-risk, high-return investments. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Click like if you like the content. And don't forget to watch the next video about the natural gas sector, which is about Gazprom. I'll see you in the next video.